Well, folks, once again, the Democratic Party revealed their true colors to us, and this time they pulled out all the stops. Many of you are familiar with the Parkland shooting incident that occurred on February the 14th around 2:20 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. A 19-year-old former student of Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School by the name of Nicholas Cruz walked inside the school where he was expelled from, shot several students and teachers, got rid of his weapon on the third floor of the building, and then exited the school with the fleeing students. 15 people were wounded, 17 were killed. The Democrats want you to forget how this idiot posted racist rants to his alt-right buddies about his hatred for Jews, blacks, and immigrants. Well, he didn't necessarily call us blacks. He called us. He also bragged about his need to kill Mexicans, keeping us black folks in chains and cutting our necks. The Democrats want you to forget how the school resource officer, Deputy Scott Peterson, refused to do his job by going into the school to face Cruz and stop him. This weak, pathetic coward of a deputy sheriff stayed outside where he is safe while innocent people were dying inside. The Democrats want you to forget that three other deputies who were also on the school grounds during the shooting did the same thing. These cowards safely waited outside during the shooting instead of going inside the school to stop Nicolas Cage like they were trained to do. The Democrats want you to forget that the FBI was contacted twice about online threats made by Nicholas Cruz of his intentions to shoot people. The FBI started a file on Nicholas Cruz, but never followed up with those tips because, well, they were too busy conspiring with each other on how they were going to get President Trump out of the Oval Office. Russia, Russia, Russia. The Democrats want you to forget that the Broward Sheriff Department were called to the home of Nicholas Cruz 45 times in reference to his violent behavior. Deputy sheriffs were called to his house for a variety of reasons, from Cruz physically attacking his mother, to threatening to shoot his brother, to killing little animals. There's more things I could tell you about this case, more things about what the Democrats don't want you to know or focus on, but I'll stop there. However, I must say this. I find it very interesting that the liberals are quick to scream, "My body, my choice," when it comes to abortions. But they're quick to deny women like me the right to protect ourselves from violent criminals who wish to rape and or kill us. So let me get this straight. I can legally kill my unborn baby because it's my body, but you want it to be illegal for me to own a gun to protect my body? Really? I'm a proud member of the NRA and a gun owner who currently live alone. I feel safe inside my home due to those reasons. Any criminal who breaks inside my home wishing to do me harm will be staring down the barrel of my AR-15. But looky, looky, a generation of Tide Pod eaters want to take that right away from me. Looks like history is repeating itself. The same Democratic Party that created the KKK wants to turn me into a victim. The same Democratic Party who created Jim Crow laws want to turn me into a statistic. And the same Democratic Party who organized lynch mobs to hang my ancestors want to deny me the right to defend myself. The Republican Party was founded to help black people, while the Democrats did the opposite. But now the Democrats not only want to disarm blacks, but they want to disarm law-abiding Americans in general. These people hate America, and they hate the United States Constitution and wish to abolish it. For the past 2 years, liberals have been working hard to abolish our First Amendment rights in reference to our freedom of speech. Today, they're working on repealing the Second Amendment, our rights to own guns. So what amendment will Democrats work on repealing in the future? How about the 13th Amendment? Don't laugh. It's not far-fetched. Remember, it was the Democrats who fought to keep slavery legal. So if they're trying to get rid of our First and Second Amendment, why would they stop there? I'm tired of the fake outrage mobs. I'm tired of the hypocrisy. I'm tired of conservatives apologizing to these regressive libtards. But most of all, I am tired of privileged liberals who live in gated communities in a city where the average income is over $150,000 try to speak on my behalf. Not only do these people make that much money, but 70% of them work in white-collar professions. And they have the nerve to create a protest called March for Our Lives. Well, what about my life? I grew up poor, raised in the ghettos of Washington, D.C. I know the importance of owning a gun for self-defense. Come midterm elections, I will vote for Republicans who believe that I should keep that right. My question to you is, what are you going to do?